In 2019, we published our Equality, Human Rights and Diversity Policy, which was designed to build on a range of existing Arts Council work areas. While we've led on and supported a lot of work in the areas of access and opportunity, we see this policy as a much more wide-ranging corporate policy that puts the principles of equality, diversity and inclusion at the heart of everything we do. How we're structured, how we operate, who we are and who and what we support. As the agency tasked with the development of the arts in Ireland, we think it is crucial that the Arts Council takes a proactive and focused approach to guaranteeing a basic human right. That's to ensure that everyone who lives in Ireland has the opportunity to engage with and participate in the arts. We specifically named the 9 protected characteristics in equality legislation as the areas under which we want to ensure equality of opportunity, access and outcomes for people. We've also added the 10th ground of socioeconomic status because we know that there is continued and profound inequity on class grounds in terms both of those who work in the arts and those who attend and participate. Above all, we want this to be a living policy, not written and then shelved, but a live, active policy open to response, further shaped, and if necessary, challenged by its many stakeholders. For that reason, a big part of the document is an initial 3-year action plan where we've set ourselves a number of goals and deadlines. This plan has 28 actions, and these are linked to our 10-year strategy, Making Great Art Work. The most important areas we want to address include representation. We want to see better representation of the society in which we live within our own structures and systems. That covers our board, staff, peer panels we put together for different awards, and ultimately, in the artists and organisations with whom we work. In developing the policy, we consulted with a wide range of different representative groups and civil society bodies. And the central message ringing out clearly was, you cannot be what you cannot see. So a number of our actions are focused on creating opportunities for people who experience barriers to working in the arts and ensuring more diverse voices and perspectives are brought to our policy, planning, and decision-making processes. We need to be able to set targets for change and to be able to measure that change. To do this, we need to collect accurate and relevant data about who we're supporting and who we reach. Any artists applying for awards will now see questions asked about their gender, ethnicity, and disability status. Of course, this has no bearing whatsoever on the assessment of the application, but it's a way of us gaining an accurate picture of who's applying for and receiving Arts Council support. And it will inform any future actions we might take to create equitable opportunities for artists from all backgrounds to make art. We'll also be working with the organisations we fund to collect better information about who the ultimate beneficiaries of this public funding are. Partnerships and new collaborations are very important to us, and we want to work in partnership with the art sector to bring about change. More importantly, we have to ensure that the voices of those who are excluded and marginalised lead the conversation. And we intend to form firm collaborative partnerships with representative groups and civil society bodies to this end. And finally, we want to embed this policy into everything we do. So this first action plan is being incorporated into all other plans and policies which we develop. Our key mission is that art and culture in Ireland is of, for, and about everyone in Ireland. And there's a very strong will across the Arts Council to proactively bring about change based on a clear vision around the absolute need for greater diversity to ensure the continued enrichment of the artistic landscape and to extend the ambition, relevance and vibrancy of the arts in Ireland today. The full policy is available here on our website in Irish and English, and we've shortened versions of it in the 10 most spoken languages in Ireland. There's also a large print version. Please do feel free to get in touch with us about this, and we look forward to working with you to reach our goal of ensuring that everyone who lives in Ireland has the opportunity to engage with and participate in the arts.